Scripture reading comes from Job, chapter number 12, and we'll begin with verse number 7. But ask the animals, and they will teach you, the birds of the air, and they will tell you. Ask the plants of the earth, and they will teach you. And the fish of the sea will declare to you. Who among all these does not know that the hand of the Lord has done this? In God's hand is the life of every living thing and the breath of every human being. May God bless the reading and hearing of this word. May we each hear in it a word that is to us and for us on this day. It is Earth Day. Celebration of the earth that brings us together today. It brings us together to celebrate the beauty of creation for sure. But as we have already noted and will continue to note, this time it brings us at the Congregational Church of Pinehurst together for a particular reason and a particular celebration as we dedicate our solar panels, brought into reality by the vision of some, by the determination of some, and by the generosity of many. As much as anything, however, Earth Day brings us together to acknowledge our temporariness. There's a lot of syllables in that word. It's hard to get it to roll off the tongue. We are asked to lean into the reality that those who have gone before us have passed the stewardship of the planet along to us. Perhaps in some ways they have done that well, and perhaps in some ways not. They cared for it and passed it along to us. Whatever its condition, as we have received it, it is ours to care for. But in our temporary state, we will soon enough pass it along to another generation. In our temporary state as stewards, the driving questions become, what will we leave behind? What will our earth legacy be? What resources will remain? And what possibilities will remain for those who come after us? Earth Day brings us together to ask some important questions. A member of our church family recently shared a book which had been meaningful to him. He asked that I read it, and I did. And the title of the book is Ishmael, subtitle, An Adventure of the Mind and Spirit. The book is an effort to understand humanity and the ways that we have moved about and lived together over the course of history. In the book, human beings are broken down into two categories in what I think is an interesting way. Takers and leavers. Takers are members of the dominant culture, and going all the way back to Adam and Eve, they can be found living as if human beings rule the earth. They believe that human beings have almost unlimited potential and are capable of growing until they dominate the planet. Technology, perhaps the entire universe. In the course of this growth, the takers assume that all of the resources of the planet are available to meet their needs and their efforts at domination. On the surface, it appears that the takers are doing pretty well and are on track toward their goals and have outwitted the rules that govern other populations and species on the earth. Now, I'm about to change pronouns because most of us in this room likely, if we are honest, have one foot in the takers' world and one foot in the leavers' world. And part of our Earth Day service is us to ask some questions and figure out where we want to plant both of our feet. So here's the pronoun change. We, the takers, at least the part that each of us prone to take, we have some problems. Our system is in big, big trouble. We're discovering slowly, and perhaps not so slowly anymore, that the resources which sustain life have been diminished and are now being diminished in an accelerating fashion. Here is the thing that about Earth Day services, which call us together not only to celebrate, but to embrace some hard truths. And perhaps the hardest truth of them all is that the taker culture is in a free fall and is doomed to crash. That's easier to say on a gloomy day than a day full of sunshine, but it remains true. So, what about believers? What are they up to? What is their agenda? On the surface, they don't seem to be in control of much. You see, the believers aren't interested in dominance because of a core belief that they carry in their soul. It is a belief in interdependence, which exists between them and the earth, them and other human beings, them and other species with whom we share the planet. Beyond this belief in interdependence, believers believe that all the earth resources which sustain life on earth, that they are finite. That they have a beginning and that they will have an end. And because of that, there is a question with which they wrestle constantly. And that is, what will they leave behind for tomorrow? Now, let me change the pronouns again. We and the lever within us, we've done a lever thing. Let's call it that. These solar panels, which we celebrate today, which we dedicate today, they will do more than illuminate the room where we gather to worship. They will do more than light the way for the children who gather here during the week at our Montessori school. They will serve as a testament. They will serve as a witness. They will announce that in this respect, we have chosen a lever path. Susan Holbechi in The Way Ahead tells the story of a teacher who had a student who was misbehaving and not really paying attention during her geography lesson. And so she took a big map of the world and she tore it into pieces. Thinking an impossible task, she assigned the putting together of the putting the world back together to the boy who was misbehaving. She was surprised when in less than 10 minutes he came back with the earth restored, taped together and perfect. When she inquired as to how he did it, he said, "When I turned the pieces over, I found a picture of a person, and I knew how to put them back together. And then I looked at the other side, and the world was whole again as well." You see, when we make intentional choices to leave instead of take, we become a little bit more whole. And the world becomes, at least in some small way, a bit more whole as well. Last week, I was away. I hope you noticed, at least, that I was away. I was at Johns River Valley Camp, where we had a women's retreat, which has been going on forever and has all of these traditions associated with it, which you better not change, I found out in my few years at the camp. It's been going on long enough that the older generation of women are now sharing the traditions and the retreat with a younger generation of women who are now taking on leadership. I led a worship service on Sunday morning shortly before the retreat concluded. For the telling of this story, you need to know that the camp is a beautiful place, but the terrain is challenging, it's hilly and undulating. During that service, one of the older members of the group shared how much difficulty she had had in getting around that weekend. Barely even able to make it to the dining hall for some of the meals, she said. And then she named three of the younger participants. participants who had walked with her wherever she went once they noticed her struggle. And she called them her angels, who, in her words, helped her get to where she needed to go. I found it deeply illustrative of community. For the day will come when the generation which comes after us will be assigned the duty of taking care of us. I have four children, and I look at them constantly and wonder which one's going to come through. Such is life's cycle. But until then, while we have energy and breath, while we have imagination and determination, while we hold a belief in self which empowers us but is tempered by our greater belief in God, while we can and while we know we should, we will loosen our grips on some of the things which sustain life so we might lay them down that they might be picked up by those who follow us. An old man, a member of a Hasidic community, spent the waning years of his life in the daily practice of going out to the edges of the property and planting fig trees. His friends and family community members badgered him about this and asked, "Why in the world are you using what energy you have left to plant fig trees that you will never see grow?" I liked the old man's answer because it was succinct. He said, "Because I like figs." And the figs that I have eaten were planted by somebody else. And now it is my turn. Perhaps not always. In fact, certainly not always. It is our turn to leave behind the things which sustain our lives and will sustain the lives of our children and their children and their children's children. So yes, indeed, today is a day to celebrate. It is a day to remember that it is our turn to be leavers. Amen.